ఆదిభ్యో బ్రహ్మ విద్యా సంప్రదాయ కర్తృభ్యో వంశ ఋషభ్యో మహద్భ్యో నమో గురుభ్యః సర్వోప్లవరహిత ప్రజ్ఞాన ఘన ప్రత్యగర్థో బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి సోహమస్మి బ్రహ్మాహమస్మి. ఓం ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, కంప్లీట్ ఎంజాయ్మెంట్ విత్ సౌభాగ్యంస్, లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ అవర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ద క్రీచర్ ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్. Let us begin today's session of Bhagavad Gita, verse number 48 of second chapter. Shri Bhagavan uvacha yogasthah kur karmani sangam tyaktva dhananjaya siddhya siddhyo samo bhotva samatvam yoga uchyate. Krishna uses commanding language to Arjuna. He says, Arjuna, kuru karmani, you have to perform karma but being in the yoga. Yoga staha, being established yourself in the yoga, in the buddhi yoga, you have to perform karma. But sangam tektva dhananjaya, having detachment or giving up attachment of karma phala, without attaching yourself the desire of karma pala, you have to work karma. In the last words, he cleared one more thing. Don't be desirer of inaction. Do you know what it means? It means don't be a desirer of holiday resorts. Because in holiday resorts, you have a kind of attachment. And places like Ooty, Kodaikanal, Simla, Kullu Manali, these places are more attracted to you. Why? Because you want to be free from your responsibility to enjoy your family. Not even with family, to enjoy your time without the responsibility. You feel very good. Don't be endowed with is inaction. Inaction means what? Always mind is fond of to get free from the responsibility. Don't be endowed with that. And also, don't pretend like the author of karma, because Ishvara is the author of karma. You are not. That is the fact. He says, yogasthaha kuru karmani, but sangam tyaktva. Now, he says, buddhi yoga is your life. For example, when I take you from here to Delhi, when you sleep, we take you with the bed and we take to Delhi and bring back here. Don't think about the duration. You have a long sleep. We took by flight and we brought back. Now, the next day morning, if anybody asked you, did you go to Delhi? Then you would say that, no, of course not. Just I had a very sound sleep in my room alone. Is it true or not? When you are aware, when you travel with your awareness, means consciousness, you feel the travel, your body doesn't feel the travel, okay? The travel is for you. When you travel with consciousness, you are taken away because words are eye-catching, attractive, because they are, all of them are endowed with the expectation of karma phala. When your mind goes away to an object, that object will capture you, will pull you. Then what? You will set a desire to achieve that. Now what? You become karma phala desirer. Once you become attracted to that karma phala, you will start traveling towards out. Krishna says, don't travel towards out. Buddhi is the door. You know, one survey had happened 10 years before. It said, man, he stops his growth of intelligence after 13 years. Up to 13 years, the man or woman, human being, they get a tremendous growth of an intellect. That intellectual aspects of growth, it stops after 13 years. That survey goes like this. Because we stop, when we were in the childhood, we want to learn everything with open mind. After a certain stage of our life, we want to convey, means we want to accumulate the object according to our expectations. We don't worry about the real nature of those objects. Just I wish I should get the car which I wish. Therefore, so many, you know, you have choices. The world means what? It's varieties of choices. All of them are ready to occupy you. That occupy you means what? In order to pluck you from you. Be careful. Be careful means how can we be careful? Because world is very captivating, means eye-catching. I'm not able to hold my mind. Many people ask these questions. I'm not able to control my mind. Is there any way to control? Your buddhi is the way. Buddhi is the door between inner and outer life. When you travel through that door towards out, you cannot hold you back. Therefore, what? You have to shut the door, or you have to learn an art to travel through inside with the same door called buddhi. Sir, it is very impossible, Swamiji. It seems to be very easy, but it is most difficult job, I tell you, but most easier job. Because when the world is eye-catching, there are certain materials, objects are artificially created but thoroughly established called temples. The mind has the tendency to go out. Paranchikani vatranath swayambhohu na parang pasyati nantaratman kaschit dhera pratyagatmanam aikshat avrta chakshur amurtatvam icchan. These all organs have been created towards outside. They prevent man to travel inside. Only they take towards outside. That is the deficiency of the organ. But we have to cheat our sensory organs very nicely. Go to Badrinath Yatra. Go to Kailash Yatra. Go to 51 Shakti Pitha Yatra, 108 Vaishnava Sthalas Yatra, where you are going just to have darshan of Mahavishnu, Lord Maheshwara, Lord Durga Saraswati Lakshmi. Now, those travels, though you are traveling outside, but those traveling will help you to travel inside. You should know how to travel. Once we had a travel, I had taken 150 people. So one among them, he was very intelligent, good personality, good man. By heart, he was having a helping tendency to all. He used to provide food for all the participants of that yatra many times. But he had only one tendency. Wherever he go, he had abundance knowledge about so many things. At airport, we were waiting by 5 o'clock in the morning for the next flight to catch to Rishikesh. From Rishikesh, we used to go to Badrinath. Still, I am taking every year people to Badrinath and Kedarnath. In between whatever the temples they come, So I take all of them to all the temple. I don't live any places in Himalayas because I lived there for 15 years. I know all the places how to be reached. We were waiting at the airport and he was wandering here and there and he was calling his wife who was not there. She picked up early in the morning, 5 o'clock, and he was asking her to take the note of some glasses which was decorated in the airport. I was amazed, my God, what is he doing? He was ordering this glass and capturing with WhatsApp and sending to his wife. Then finally, what he said was, you know, just all the things which I am sending, I have been sending for 4 days. All the material, totally 170 material, noted down all those materials. I have to get it within a month. Ask manager to go ahead for that. My God, then I realized this man, I thought he was traveling with me, but he was traveling in the different direction. He was just sitting nearby me. My world is different because we were chanting mantras and we were thinking about Badrinath and Kedarnath. I was narrating all the stories in order to be focused to the Almighty. But this person, wherever he used to go, he was all keen to the object outside and taking the note to get for his business at his home. I was terrified, became tensed, but I didn't say, because good at heart, he was having helping tendency, but the travel, the route was something different. From that point, when we landed to the Rishikesh, I asked him to give his mobile. He said that he was very shocked. Swamiji, so why, what happened? Is there any rules? Should I not carry this? Then I said, it's not like that. I would like to talk to your wife. Then he rang, gave it to her. I spoke with her, Amma. So he is traveling with me. I thought he got connected with Lord Mahavishnu, but he is still with you. Means he is still at your home, in your city. He is always thinking that, oh, by seeing all the objects, this object, if it is in my house, how it would be? He is keep on thinking, he is not traveling at all, only his body is traveling. What should I do? Should I send him back or should I take him with me? This is what I asked, just he realized. He apologized. I said, need not to be apologized. This is yatra. This yatra, if it is to be given proper fruit, you are the yatri who should know how to travel. From that moment, he was endowed with bhajan, kirtan, mantras, japa. That's what, when you do yatra inside, not outside. That's what buddhi yoga. This life is endowed with so many incidents and accidents which are nothing but karma phala. Be careful with them. Use your buddhi. That's what buddhi yoga. Travel is not outside. Completely travel is inside. You are the person who can use your free will to select the choices in you, not from outside. You can go, you can allow yourself to travel along with the object, whatever the object comes in front of you, or you can prevent that outgoing and you can go travel innerwards by having the travel of Lord Mahavishnu or Parameshwara. When you go to Badrinath, you just chant and endowed with Badrinath. From home to Badrinath, that travel, whole travel, whoever you see, whatever that you eat, whatever the thought comes, everything, please see as they, all of them are nothing but Vishnu's phalam prasadam. Then what? You are not traveling towards out. You are traveling towards in to see the Badrinath who is in you in the form of super consciousness, Atma or Brahman. That is the beauty of our forefathers. They have established huge temples in many places, thousands of temples. You need not to have other engagement. Every week you can travel. Use all the weekends to travel to the temple. Joyful, that's inner journey. Begin the realm of inner journey and be enjoyful life endowed with. It's a fantastic lifestyle which is gifted by our forefathers. Make use of it. Leave it all the holidays resort. What do you do in the holidays resort? You go and sleep and gamble and something, you lose your health, you lose your peace of mind. When you come back, you are so tired. Then what? Some kind of diseases comes. We don't know what kind of diseases comes, because when you become very drowsy, sleepy, you cannot maintain your health. But when you go to pilgrim, you have to climb the mountain, you have to follow certain rituals, because you can be endowed with upavasa and you can also do parayana, you can earn more punya. This is beautiful society is being established by our forefather, in which you can use buddhi yoga and you can also convert that journey as the real journey in our life. That's what Krishna says. Kuru karmani, don't desire to be silent, desire to keep yourself muted mobile or switched off mobile. Activate your life, not mobile always. Okay. Therefore, sangam tektva dhananjay. Hey dhananjaya, having given up the attachment towards karma phala, please endowed with you buddhi yoga. Siddhi hasiddhyoho samo bhutva. This is what called being in the middle, to be in the middle, not taking a path of papa or punya. Then from next words, he talks about prayojana, the benefit of this buddhi yoga. Buddhi yoga means it's a great boon. That's what bhavana. First, we have to realize what exactly buddhi yoga means. To be endowed with bhavana, that bhavana, I am not the author. Because when you perform karma, automatically you get the notion of the doership, that I am the author. You replace it, I am not the author. My karma phala is author. That karma phala is given by Ishvara. Now Ishvara is the author, I am not the author. Then finally, the final stage, which Gita will say that Ishvara and me are the same. It comes in forthcoming chapter. Therefore, now here, just you realize what is buddhi yoga. Now there are two kinds of gurus in the world. The people who are attached with karma phala, the people who are not attached with karma phala, still they are endowed with karma. Now two groups are there. The person who has realized the truth, he performs the karma but not attached with karma phala. Then the person who is endowed with karma and also attached with karma phala, that's what he says. Durena hyavaram karma buddhi yoga dhananjaya buddhau sharanam ichcha kripana phala hetavah. So beautifully he says, the buddhi yoga karma durena hi avaram. These people who work for karma phala, they are inferior people than who work without having attachment towards karma phala. This is better than, far better than the second one. Means second one means who is attached with karma phala. Therefore, please surrender yourself to this buddhi yoga. It is the refuge that you can do. If you continue with karma phala attitude, you will find definitely hell. Phalahetavaha means if you select that marga by using your free will, you are the person who could select. Therefore, we saw kartumva, akartumva, anyatava, kartum shakyam. Every individual, we have a capacity to select karma, not to select karma phala. You bring in your mind all this understanding, select proper, attitude to be endowed with karma, to have a proper journey of life. He continues, buddhi yukto jahati hai ubhe sukrta duskrute tasmad yoga yayujyasva yoga karma shukaushalam. Then he says, buddhi yuktaha iha ubhe sukrta duskrute jahati. The person, one who is endowed with buddhi yoga, he gives up all kinds of punya and papa here itself, not to reach Vaikuntha, not to go to Kailasha to get moksha. Here alone he becomes completely liberated one, my dear. Be understandable one. Be one who is well versed in buddhi. Tasmad yogaya yujyasva yoga karmasu kaushalam. Therefore, be endowed with this buddhi yoga to establish buddhi yoga in all karma is the talent. That is the talent means that is yogam, that is spiritual progress. Now you see, it depends on you. Will you be a buddhi yuktaha? Yuktaha means who is endowed with buddhi yogaha or karma phala yuktaha. If you want to travel hereafter as the person who is detached to karma phala, you have the choice to continue with who attached with karma phala. That you have to desire. You have to be liberated here itself. That is the great life, Arjuna, you can carry it with. This is what prayojana is. When you are endowed with buddhi yoga, you are liberated. Then next word, karma jam buddhi yuktahi phalam tyaktva manishinaha janma karma vinirmuktaha padam gacchantya namayam. Now he finalizes and also talks about benefit. Janma bandha vinirmuktaha anamayam padam gacchanti. The people who are endowed with buddhi yoga, those people, they just give up their all karma phala and they get liberated from all kinds of bondage, the bondage which is earned by many janma. They reach the padam. Padam means to the highest state where there is no sorrow at all. They reach means they gain here itself. Ihaiva, here itself, need not to travel anywhere. At your home itself, if you have a proper understanding, realization about all of these things, you will be liberated. Now the fruit is here. Need not to travel anywhere. Next, yada te moha kalilam buddhir vyatitarishyati tada gantasi nirvedam shrotavyasya shrutasya cha. If you keep endowed with this buddhi yoga, you will gain a capacity of vairagya. If you are able to come across delusion, it is a magic. Yada te moha kalilam buddhihi vyatitarishyati yata te buddhihi moha kalilam vyatitarishyati. When your buddhi, your intellect means free will, by using free will, when you select a proper path to travel inside, that time you get the qualification of to be a buddhi yogi. Tada gantasi nirvedam shrotavyasya shrutasya cha. This is not for all. Krishna wants to bring here for our note, as a notification, this is not easy for all. When you realize, I have to travel, so I have to give it up, the attachment towards karma phala, that's not that much easy. You need to have Ishvara's grace for that. Therefore, he says, be endowed with bhakti, be endowed, means be endowed with Lord in the form of upasana. Therefore, this world has got kind of deluding tendency. Your mind itself will delude. It will say that Badrinath mein kya hai? Let us go for some yatra, Paris, Swiss, like the mind, be careful. Then he will say that you get vairagya, means a matured level. Whatever is experienced, whatever had heard as the experience. Now you see, if you are a 40-year-old, you might have seen Ooty, Kodaikanal, Simla, and Kullu Manali, and where so many other places are there. Those all places will be in your plan to go there. Certain places you might have seen. So after seeing again, if you want to go again, that is samskara vasat. So that experience wants to be hunt again, therefore you will definitely go. And if you have not been to Paris, somebody have told that Vahampe, there is something very enjoyable which we had, then you will set as a goal. He says, once you got the punya pala, luck, you can give it of both which are experienced, which are yet to be experienced. Shrotavyasya, shrutasya cha. You get a kind of detachment maturity. That maturity is a progress of spiritual. He continues, that we will see in the next episode tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Om Namo Venkateshaya.